Today, we are reviewing Transformers, Rise of the Beast, Voyager, Optimus, Prime.
Hey there, ladies and gentlemen. It's Jay here, SJK, in the house, and we are taking a look at the Transformers, Rise of the Beast, Voyager, Optimus Prime. And wow, what a mouthful. Now, here we are. Here's this figure. Honestly, just to get right into it, let's take a look at this guy. Let's see if we could have the camera focus here. There we go. You can see the beautiful detailing on the figure, which is very, very reminiscent of the Bumblebee Optimus Prime. The design cues are different, but they're far off from the Bumblebee Prime. But as you can see, he has a pretty good face sculpt. Autobot logos here. All he really is missing, that this figure is missing, is paint. But for the price that you are paying for this figure, and considering it's not a studio series, I think it's forgivable. It's a very good looking figure for what it is compared to a studio series. And he's only like a head shorter than the studio series Bumblebee Optimus, which I will be showing off here in a little bit before I end the video. But I guess we'll move on to his accessories and articulation and all that good stuff. Okay, so for articulation, his head cannot move up or down. Well, I suppose it could move down like that, but that's for the transformation. He can do full 360 around the neck, exorcist style. Shoulder will move up and down like that. Full 360 at the arm. Bend at the elbow. Full 360 right there. And then full 360 at the wrists. Wrist can't move like that, but that's for transformation purposes. You can fake a ab crunch like that. You can move the waist. Well, not the waist, the upper abdomen. But honestly, that's just because of transformation. But it does help articulate when you want to pose them. You have these nice flaps right here, so you can do the splits. Okay, kick that far up, kick that far back, spin 360 right there at the thigh, and knee can bend like that. Move the foot right there like that, and like that, and like that. A lot of the articulation is really good, but it's honestly because of the transformation. So it looks out and having really good articulation. So pretty good. He comes with this rifle. Super simple, no real paint. And then here's the rifle that the Bumblebee Studio Series Optimus comes with. And it pretty much looks like it's a miniature version of that, which makes sense because this Optimus pretty much is just like a scaled down version of the Studio Series one. So here we have him in his truck mode, and then here's his little rifle. which you could store right there. And he's a cute little truck. He's pretty cool. Like I said earlier about the robot mode, it still stands here. All he really needs is paint. And other than that, he's a pretty cool, neat, shrunken down version of a Studio Series figure. But you know what? It's so easy to go back and just paint this, honestly. It wouldn't take too much effort. Maybe I'll do it later on and post it on the channel. But this is a good looking, cute little truck for what it is. No paint on the wheels. Look at all that detail. And the transformation was so simple, guys. I really wish that the Studio Series Optimus had a transformation like this with a couple differences, but this is a clean transformation, and I really dig the design of this truck. I really like how they went about the transformation. Really don't like these flaps, but it's not bad. It's a pretty cool, neat truck overall. I cannot complain. This is pretty cool, honestly. And for a size comparison, here we have them with the Studio Series Bumblebee Optimus Prime. I guess it's the only comparison that people will really care about is this one. So as you can see, Bumblebee Prime is obviously bigger, but it's a more expensive figure. The other Studio Series that we're going to get of this guy will most likely be this size. Here we have them with the Studio Series Optimus Prime from the Bumblebee movie. It's like father and son. So final thoughts, let's get right to it. Size-wise, the Voyager for the mainline figures of the Transformers Rise of the Beast, this Optimus Prime is a head shorter than the Studio Series one. He is very well articulated. He has amazing details throughout his entire body. He has a super simple transformation that is very fun to transform without it being overly complicated. And it's not so easy that it's like baby's first transformer. It's like complicated enough for it to be satisfying. Beautiful figure. In all aspects, you know, his gun is a scaled down version of the Studio Series. Him overall is a scaled down version of the Studio Series. It's a very, very good figure. Very impressed with this. I love this. This is awesome. I cannot wait to check out the Optimus Primal. You know, if you guys can, you know, go ahead and pick this guy up when he hits the stores. For all of you wondering where I got this, Mexico. I got it from Mexico. I didn't get it in some illegal way or fashion. So, you know, stop thinking that to yourself. I got it from Mexico. across the border. But very beautiful figure. Super impressed. But thank you for joining me and checking out this Optimus Prime. And hopefully you guys will join me in checking out Optimus Primal and whatever other figures I get my hands on from Transformers Rise of the Beast. I can't wait. All right, guys, so do me a favor. Hit that like button and subscribe. Share my videos to a friend who likes this type of Transformer review, figure, whatever unboxing thingy video like this. And remember, no matter what time of day it is or what time of night it is, no matter where you are in life, smile. The strongest always smile. And I'll catch you guys on the next one.